So commodities will come off of their own accord, I believe.
Yeah, when you say come off, what are you saying exactly?
Come off their highs and go and retrace downward, perhaps giving up 20 or 30 or 40 or even 50% of their gains that they've made since they were on the bottom.
Now, how does this tie in? Because what I'm hearing, Mr. Robert Chapman, and please explain this to me and the listeners, I'm hearing now that we're in a deflationary period. All the while that I know, as sure as God made little green apples and babies, that this inflation that's going, this hyperinflation that's going to hit us, you know, I mean, folks, you think we're joking when we talk about Zimbabwe, or we're talking about the mark over in Germany when they had their problems at the turn of last century. Bob, explain this, please.
Well, the position that they're in is that you've got to understand and believe the underlying premise, and that is that all of this is being done deliberately to take us to our knees so that we'll accept world government. And if you accept that premise, then you go to the facts. When are they going to do what? And they are going to, I think, this fall, do the things that I just described. And that is not the end of it, so to speak. These are all dry runs for lower prices in the dollar, in the stock market. Pressure will continue to build against commodities. And the only place that you're going to be safe with your money is in gold and silver-related assets. And the only way that they can even keep the economy afloat is because we have this underlying deflation, and we've had it for almost 6 years, and they've been treating it up until 2 years ago with increased money and credit. You saw that with an average increase of 14% annually for 5.5 years. So they've given all this money out, but it's not doing the job. They need more. I predicted in January that the administration would try to get legislation passed for another stimulus of $2 trillion, with the legislation probably being passed in January or February. And here we have, about a month ago, two connected people talked about it, and now Stiglitz is talking about it, and he is probably one of the better economists. Give Keynesianism a chance. And Keynesianism is a failure. What they're doing is just getting us deeper in debt and buying time. And he knows that.
Well, yeah.
And so, wait a minute.
Yeah, go ahead.
I don't think they're going to give, Congress is not going to give the administration the money. I think with the howling from the people, I don't think they're going to do it. So what the Fed will do is instruct the banks to let fly that $100 billion that they've got and lend it out. And when they do that, they'll extend their timeline. They'll buy maybe 6 months or maybe even a year of sideways movement in the economy. But they'll also create hyperinflation, because that money has never been monetized, and when it does get monetized, it'll explode.
Let me try to tackle this, because I've said this before. You know, when they were doing the TARP and the TALF and this bailout, that bailout, the credit markets are tight in this country. Well, you know, they've got to rein in. They've got to make sure their books are okay before they can start lending. You know, Bob, can I not at least have the pleasure of having credit available when I'm facing economic tsunami here, that at least I'll have a job before the hyperinflation hits? Why must they make, they've already got them on the credit teat. Why must they make people suffer? They created the damn system. Why not give the illusion and the benefit of at least keeping them satiated and happy with their beer and their cable television up until the time the damn thing collapses? Are these people that frickin' evil?
Absolutely. They are so diabolically evil, it is beyond anybody's imagination. And I learned this 50 years ago, and that's why I've been in the trenches that long, because my role in life is giving one big pain in the butt, and I'm doing that. Because very few people can easily explain so people can understand what these people are up to. And that's what they're up to, and that's what they're going to do. And if they get the $2 trillion, well, they won't have to let the banks loose. They can ride for another probably about 9 months to a year. So we'll have sideways movement probably for a couple of years. But they'll be back to the same problem again. And at the same time, unemployment is going to increase because it's the only way.
Now they
can make money.
They have over a quadrillion worth of deficits, folks. And if you don't know what a quadrillion is, you probably can't even get your mind wrapped around what $1 trillion is. That's a $1 trillion is $1,000 billion. Okay, they're talking 23.7. We're in the hole right now. More stimulus, another couple trillion here, another couple. Well, what does it matter when the numbers get so high? Only a damn dog can hear them. But I'm looking at this, and I keep thinking to myself, somebody, I mean, if the gig is up, what are these people afraid of in this country? The people that are in position that should be yapping their traps right now and saying, whoa, wait a minute. Maybe we should be paying attention to Mr. Ron Paul. Maybe we should audit that Fed. Maybe we should visit whether the United States should cancel its charter with the Federal Reserve. Why not do it? Are they that afraid?
They're all paid off, and they are afraid of their lives, every single one of them. And the ones that aren't paid off are compromised through their strange lifestyles, which they don't want anybody to know about.
Mm.
And they got them all bought and paid for. You're not going to get any satisfaction. Look, you got 1207 bottled up in a committee by Barney and Nancy Pelosi, and they're not going to let it out. Is that what democracy's all about? The game is over. They're going to push the people to the edge, and there will be revolution.
Let me read something here, and I got this from Bernadine Smith. Now, Bernadine Smith, Second Amendment Committee out in California, out of Hanford, California, is not subject to fanciful renderings, let's just say. And she sent me this, and she said, you know, John, this is one of these things you're damned if you do and you're damned if you don't. This is the information that she had. Air assets will be used against populace and police in the continental United States. On Friday, the 7th of August, information from deep background sources pertaining to meeting content from high level of federal government concerning the following. The new interoperability of communication systems, which has linked city, county, and state police communications to federal agencies and NORTHCOM, including all foreign troops and mercenaries, will be used to impede and shut down local police comms so that effective containment of civil unrest due to upcoming flu pandemic / dollar collapse will be nearly impossible. The United States military and federal LEO agencies, intel agencies, as this person puts it, the Luciferian faction, wants the local police to fail, so the external forces will be brought in hard against the U.S. populace and against the police as well. If necessary, police vehicles will be taken out by force to ensure that response to riots, uprising, civil disobedience will fail and allow a Mad Max scenario to run full measure, hence giving pretext for usage of NORTHCON troops, foreign troops, and mercenaries against Americans. Medical personnel, including doctors, nurses, EMTs, and other hospital personnel, will be precluded from offering effective medical response to flu pandemic and treatment of injuries due to civil uprising and military-style attack upon the populace. Ostensibly, this will be initially done by locking down hospitals, clinics, and doctors' offices under the guise of protecting them, but really to ensure max kill from the pandemic biologicals and shoot-to-kill orders of troops, internal and external. Significant air assets will be brought to bear against the American populace and any police who resist, including helicopter gunships, armed drones, fighter aircraft, larger C-130s and spooky weapon platforms, as he says, and tank buster type aircraft. Also expected to use the use of knockout gases and, if needed, nerve agents is indicated. Now, this will happen in conjunction with vehicle armor and airborne operations, which will place NORTHCOM foreign troops and mercenary troops into selected target areas for search and destroy and containment operations. Now, note, the exact date or timing was not available, but it's expected very soon. The local county and state police should immediately obtain for their own usage private radio communications gear so that they will be able to communicate with each other in the event that the feds and military come up with a snafu scenario in the new interoperability net, perhaps from real or false flag cyber problems or just system glitches they will have taken place.